Hello, I'm Dr. Wayne Day, and I'm a dermatologist in Nashville, Tennessee, and I've been helping people with poison ivy for about 30 years, and I've learned some things I thought I might share with you. If you have a rash that is often in streaks, meaning you might be able to tell where the when the poison ivy came in contact with the skin, that's where the rash appeared. That's the typical finding that we look for. And if you have previously been allergic to it, it can come up as early as the next day. Otherwise, it may take a week or more. And you may have new spots appear later because they had less of the poison ivy, poison oak, applied to them, or that area is less sensitive. So that may help you with the diagnosis. Also, in most areas, you've just got ivy and oak, you don't have sumac. You can look at geographical maps and see if you have sumac in your area. But for ivy and oak, we're looking, the plants have three leaves. Leaves three, let it be, is the old adage to remember. And they can be any size and any color, and they often surround it in with they are camouflaged almost. They look like the surrounding vegetation. So you have to look closely. So now let's move on to treatment. Here's my suggestion. You may end up seeing someone as far as treatment that may not have had as much experience or training, so they may not know, like for instance, one of the most common mistakes I see is for people to receive a 6-day dose pack. That means you take a series of cortisone pills 6 days, and you start out with a lot and it tapers over the 6 days. Well, the problem with that is it takes 12 days of treatment. Otherwise, on the 7th day, after you've just finished your 6-day dose pack, the rash comes right back. So if you happen to go to a walk-in clinic or someplace and they've given you one of those, just call back or ask for a second one. And that way you could take day 1, day 2, just alternate between the two dose packs, and that way get your 12 days of treatment. As far as topicals, the only topical that I have found effective is clobetasol foam. And it originally came out under the name of Olux, and now it's available as a generic. So for mild to moderate cases, meaning you're not covered from head to toe, there's no big blisters, then a lot of people can do better just using a topical 3 or 4 times a day, the clobetasol foam. As far as antihistamines, the allergic reaction to poison ivy is not mediated by histamine release. So the only benefit to histamines, like Benadryl or even prescription ones, would be if they help you sleep at night, because antihistamines have a sedative effect. So there's no need to fill a prescription for an antihistamine. You can just use an over-the-counter Benadryl at bedtime. But you'll probably need at least 2, because the over-the-counter 25 milligram was originally intended for children. So adults usually need more than 1. Another thing that helps are what we used to call wet compresses, as far as giving immediate relief. But now we just tell our patients to get a paper towel or a cloth and cold water on it, and lay it on the affected area for just a minute or two. Don't pat the top of it, but just lay it, and as it cools down the skin, then that's going to give a lot of relief from the itching. Poison ivy, the rash, is not contagious to yourself or others. That's a popular myth. So it can be only transmitted the first hour or so that you come in contact with the poison ivy, poison oak, plant. It reminds me of a small child who's gotten into a chocolate mess on his hands and he doesn't realize it. And then everywhere that's touched, a lot of times that's where gradually the rash will show up. So I hope this helps, and take care. Bye.